Welcome, everybody. It has been a good while, but we are finally here, ready to do a Derby Prelude. Everyone's been asking about them, like, hey, where is your Preludes at? We want to see your Derby Preludes. Well, just as a reminder, if it's a show that I am driving in, I don't do a Prelude because I do not have the time. I'm busy with my own car getting ready to run. If it's a show I'm promoting, which is Speedrome, Circle City Raceway, and my own events, again, I don't do a Prelude because I'm busy promoting tech, rules, track, everything else. So, this is one of those rare moments. We're not doing one of those. We are here at the Owen County Fair. This is their actual mid-derby during the summertime for their county fair. Normally, there's three derbies here at Spencer, Indiana a year, spring, summer, and fall. We have almost always missed this one specifically because we have gone to the Jay County Fair or we are running in our own derby at the same weekend. We just so happened to not be going to the Jay County Fair this year. They changed their rules. It's a lot more built than it was. It wasn't stock class. I'm not running a car there. And to be honest, I felt like this was going to be a better show for you guys. So me personally, we're here filming it. We're going to find out. So we're going to give you guys our usual Derby Prelude walkthrough. We're going to take our time. We're going to have some fun. We don't get many of these Preludes anymore. So let's go ahead and walk through everything and do a rundown for you guys. We'll catch up on this end here in a minute. We're going to start right here and see what's going on as we walk away around the arena. So, walking through some of these cars here, what is the class lineup for the night? So off the top of my head, I do believe we are running full-size cars. We are running mini class, mid-size class. I do believe there is a built mini class, which is probably those rules for that car there specifically. We are running minivan slash SUV class there together, and we are also running a full-size van and full-size truck class that are together. So multiple classes here today, and we're going to see a lot of vehicles than typical for this smaller show for Owen because their spring show got rained out and canceled. I was here during it. They came so close to having that derby. We were in the pits, cars were there through tech, and the storm just opened up and dumped rain about an hour before the show and did not stop. So they canceled it at the derby. It was just a muddle. Good call on their behalf. So all these people have been itching and had tons of cars built, ready to run for all that and all of this time around too. But we got probably some of our stock class full size sitting right here, the 14E and the H49 sitting here. We got Lincoln Town Car and your 80s Ford lined up back to back. We got, it looks like an Oldsmobile Silhouette minivan. I think that's a plastic bumper factory on the rear for this thing. Running the minivan class for this. Most of these classes are very stock per the rules. I think the full size class is one of the few classes where you can put chrome bumpers on your car. Almost everything else is essentially a 92 and newer bumper, or within those years, just a bumper reinforcement, as they call it. Basically anything non-chrome can be mounted onto the front of these vehicles. And almost all their classes require the bumper to be bolted on. I don't know about the full size, you might be able to weld those, not sure for that built class. But everything else is very simple, very stock thrown together, like this Prism that you see here. Real super simple, got everything out of them. I do believe with their rules this year, they changed it, and you have to put the gas tank in the car. In the past, some of their classes did allow you to put the tank still factory underneath the vehicle if it was under the middle there, like the minivans and these front-wheel drive cars would have them. But that is something new they've done this year, so we're going to see people accommodating and getting used to that, people that are not normally used to swapping the tanks and leave them underneath. We got a square body Buick, which there's several of these here. I can't believe people keep pulling these things out of the weeds. I don't see any more on the roads ever, but this is your typical A-body. This is an older style one. I can tell by these door handles. They quit making that style door handle in the earlier models and eventually switched them later on. This one actually would have had a factory chrome bumper. They painted over that, but that is a chrome underneath it. They can run that because that is original to this car for this Buick here. But that is pretty much your standard A-body. You can tell by that lower subframe, which is what we tried to run when Susan ran her square body Buick on these things. So we'll see how they hold up for the stock class. Gosh, off the top of my head, maybe we'll ask somebody later on here as we come around looking at these vehicles. I cannot remember if you can notch and pre-bend the rears of these cars or not. That is a huge rule that is important to me, and I want to know that when we look at these vehicles, because that will determine how these things are going to hold up for this stock class. Everything else you can really predict. If you are familiar with cars, guys, if you know the frames, the subframes, if you know the weak points of these front-wheel drive cars, they're really easy to predict how they're going to bend in a stock class derby. but notching, that determines everything on some of them. This here is probably something I am most excited to see this time around, and really glad they're having it this time that I'm here. This is their full-size van, full-size truck class. If you remember when I built and ran my cow van, the Utter Madness van, that was here at this derby with this class. It's still a relatively new class. When I ran it was the very first time, maybe the first time or the first year they were trying to do it, and they're trying to grow it. I really hope we get enough entries. We're gonna keep track of what we all find for that class. I want it to grow. It's just a really fun class to watch because these big things get flying, and especially these vans, boy, you can just send them backwards and there's so much damage the back ends of these vans can do. This looks like a Ford van, your 250, 350 style, leafed in the rear. This guy actually, this was a solid panel van. He cut windows in it so he can see out the sides of it. See, there's his factory tank. He's taken that out and just straight chained it to the floor. Hopefully it doesn't slide during the hits and move out from underneath him there. But yeah, I had a blast running my cow van, Tom. Absolutely fun, but boy, did you feel the hits. Now, this one does have factory bumpers. And again, remember how I mentioned some of the rules have changed. I'm wondering if that rule has changed for the full-size van and full-size truck class. When I ran it originally, you could put any chrome bumper you wanted on those big vans, those big trucks. Now you may have to run factory bumpers or whatever's on them, so that's going to absolutely affect these things. It means you won't want to use the front of these vans at all, period. It's going to be backhand only. We got a GMC, a Jimmy, old 4x4 Jimmy here, probably running it back-wheel drive, but he could be running it forwards. You can do either or for the SUV class. See a lot of people that will switch and run front-wheel drive in the SUVs just to throw off the competition. This looks like an older 70s Ford, if I were to guess. Could be a 70s LTD. I'm not sure off the top of my head. But it definitely looks like it's got the I-beam rear bumper shock. See right here, guys. If you ever see something like that, that's a dead giveaway. It's a Ford. Those I-beam shocks, as they call them, front and the rear. Boy, the back of this is gone in the trunk. Whew. But I bet that might be an LTD within that era 70s Ford. For sure, yeah, it's got the original 70s bumper on that thing. Check that out. Wow.
What year is it, Chad?
Is that an LTD?
Yeah.
I guessed it right. I was thinking so. So we got a mid-70s LTD right here.
I'll make you the proud owner of it.
Yeah, I bet afterwards, right?
Just driven to church by a little old lady. No, he's not going to run.
No?
No, he's got a problem.
Oh, it's not running right now.
No, he's going to have to fix something else on it yet.
Uh-oh.
Come up with a fuel leak, so.
Oh, that's a shame. I love these 70s Fords. They're a blast to watch. Well, hopefully, if this don't run today, hopefully we get to see this thing come out and play this fall then. So that's a shame. The 210M 70s Ford won't make it onto the track. Working our way around, we got a Bad News Crown Vic. This is definitely your built class. This is your, whatever they call it, full-size weld, modified class, whatever name they choose to use. It's essentially the same thing. The title is just different. Yeah, he's got his doors welded. I don't know how much frame welding they do. They do have solid suspension on these things. Looks like he has welded the tabs right here on the crush box. So that tells me he's either got plates in there or he's pulled this thing down and tilted it lower, whatever the rules allow for them to do that. Front bumper's been seam welded, possibly loaded. I don't know what the rules allow for these things. And it looks like we have more square body Buicks. Well, this one's a Cutlass, but essentially the same thing. Possibly both of them the same, back to back. Look at that. This is gonna be, are they the same? Yep, so we got twin cars coming out right here. We got 13B and 21B. Very, very similar builds, cars running together here. A whole bunch of these style of vehicles coming out to play this time around. Just see they pulled their tank, thrown it in the back seat, and you almost have to. If you were allowed to keep it under, I wouldn't do that for these specific cars, because these things are notorious for just blowing out right there and shoving those back tires right into the fuel tank. So the fact those are moved will buy them a lot more time before it crushes into that tank. But they got factory bumpers on these things. Usually what'll happen, especially on these right here, is that fender right there, that lower skirt's gonna roll right into that front tire, and it's gonna lock up steering on them. Real common for the A-bodies. This one too. As you can see here, this one's been wrecked. It's been hit on that bumper. So it's already got a weak spot right here on this fender. That fender's just ready to shove right in. You're better off with the Sawzall and just cut them right off. Got your 80s Ford full size. chrome bumpers are in the stock class. The old 27 wagon, used and abused, but back for more. Pretty sure we saw this thing run, didn't we? This thing looks really familiar. I think we saw this already this year run. It's hurt, but we'll see if he's here to win or here to send it. Sometimes these pre-runs are, you never know what you're going to get out of them. And right behind him, we got another full size. 72, looks like he's running the stock class as well. This one's hurt up front, starting to shove in. It's real close on them struts, my goodness. Front wheel drive is rubbing those strut pockets. Oof, that is going to lock up and kill a CV axle or something on that. That's a tall tire. Another older style. This one actually could be, I was going to say it was another Buick, but it's not. I'm pretty certain, guys, this is like your Chrysler, your New Yorkers, kind of like how we had the Fifth Ave and whatnot, your Plymouth. Is the emblem still on the dash? I can't see it. There it is. Yep, it's a New Yorker. Emblem's over there on the glove box. I was right. So it's a Chrysler New Yorker. So this thing is going, it's actually rolling up, which is a blessing for this car. These are notorious to plow down. So use it up. This thing's got the bulletproof motors in it. These things do not shut down, these Chrysler motors. It's about the best thing this car has. Let's hurry up and jump across, catch these vehicles before we roll to the front. There are two halves to the pits this time around because it's very full, so they had to go into an overflow. Normally there's not any type of derby cars parked out here. This is actually parking, so definitely pushed them all through. Minivan that's ran once and looks like they didn't even throw a spare on it. They just kept the aluminum rim and they're gonna send it just like that. Curious to see how that works out. It's a Chrysler Town and Country. Back bumper is actually starting to split right there in the middle. And this one does have the plastic rear tray, the Stone Go seats. And that one's starting to go flat on the rear too. Curious to watch that and see how that'll work out. Not running a donut, just running the rim itself. Will it actually roll? Or will it just pack a bunch of mud into the open hollow spaces and kind of lock up and just slide like a ski? We'll see how that works out for him. And here we have entry number two for the full-size van and truck class. We got a Chevy number 1776 going with the American theme here. That'll be fun to watch out there. Not too rotten, honestly, for this style of Chevy. Even the rear frame looks pretty darn good back in there. Usually these bad boys will just belly right in the middle, blow a drive shaft out there, and this truck bed will be sky high in a heartbeat. But with it being clean like that, it may last for more hits than expected. Now this one does have a tubing front bumper on it. So that means he did swap it, and he's got a stick, so he passed the tech. So that might mean you are still allowed changing your bumpers for that big van, big truck class. Here's somebody we are familiar with, the Brandon Warner Mobile. This guy actually placed, if you remember, he had a team in my team derby back when we ran that last year, the old Circle City Raceway. He was running the front wheel drive class there. They were one of the people that had two entries, a two-man team running in a three-man derby, and ended up to hold their own, by dang. So he's here running a full-size wagon. Don't know if he's ran a full-size wagon before. He's shaking his head no. So not only is he probably super pumped, but very nervous. Because everybody knows when you bring a wagon, you're always gonna be a target. If you sit still too long, someone's either driving right through your corner pillars or right through the sides of the car, but we'll see how it does. He's at least got a seat bar, so his doors aren't gonna crush him, but my goodness, look at that rust. Oh boy. I cannot wait to see what this wagon does. I don't know how it's gonna bend. Cause that's his, if you look, that's the lower trailing arm. I'm gonna get some light on that. See that lower trailing arm right there? You can see it through the floor. And then look over there. There's your strut tower, all gone. You can see the back tire through there. Oh boy, oh boy. I don't know how this is gonna bend. I mean, he's got it notched, but still, if you take a hard hit early on, that pressure might bypass the notch and just completely blow right here under these doors. And we're gonna know from the stands right away as soon as we see. If we see that back tire shift and that control arm snapped off, we know what's happening inside this. He's gonna know as he drives it because he's gonna see this absolute floor pan wrap around his gas tank and make him a little worried as it bends. But if he's lucky, nobody full tracks the back end right away and he can get that thing to roll, start packing in the back, and he'll be all right. It'll be soft enough to buy some time. That's pretty awesome. Yeah. no back bumper on it either. So we'll see how that plays effect. This is your typical like Buick Roadmaster style wagons from the 90s. A lot of sedans are ran and they do really well. We'll see the wagon version. It's got the factory front bumper for those Buicks on it. Not totally rotten up front. Cleanish frame. So we'll see how it holds out. It's going to be the N21 in the green and black wagon. Continuing around here, looks like we have probably a Ford Escort or a Mercury. Just putting the 77N sign on top of here. This is running absolutely factory bumpers. That means plastic, completely plastic back and 100% plastic front bumper that is on these Ford Escorts. So this is going to be a car that you just let it rip and fold right in. Guard your front end. Jumping back over here, catch these cars. Another pre-ran here, the number 410, starting to push in. This looks like a Cavalier. Yep. Talk about that front bumper. It's a factory Chevy Cavalier front bumper. It's definitely been used up, but the frame rails are not kicking. Usually these Cavaliers, them frame rails love to kick to the side, but he's got a flat already. That's probably not a good sign on a front-wheel drive car. So I don't know what the story is on this thing. He's gonna have to switch the tires. He's got a flat back tire. Hopefully he's got something to put on that. If he brings it out like that, then we know he's not here to win. He's here to just kill the car. We'll see. But boy, check out that wiring harness. You guys have seen some crazy stuff on my cars. Look at that. Those wires are just laying out in the open right by the lower mount hanging from the transmission. I hope somebody doesn't get under there and catch them and just rip them right out. Over here we got a 2000s Buick. It's got the factory aluminum front bumper, just like the Buick LeSabre that I ran. Even has the 3800 engine. I can see you looking down in there. There's your 3800 engine. Almost the exact same motor, everything. Probably the exact same car that I derbied. Wonder if he's got 15s or 16s.
Do I put the blade back?
No, he's actually got 15s on this thing. Look at that. He managed to get some steel 15s to fit on there. That's surprising. These things come with 16s. So cool, he got those to clear. There's the aluminum factories on the back. Oh, this is the Park Avenue. Sorry, not LeSabre. Same thing, same frame. It's got a flat back here. It's been hit. I don't know if this has been a pre-ran or what the deal is on this one. Might have been. Looking around here, we got a 80s town car. Tubing bumpers. He's running probably in the built class. Definitely with a rear end like that. My goodness. Boy, this thing looks like it's been in a rollover. Holy cow, look at that roof. I'm gonna guess this was a car that was in a crash on the road, because that kind of damage doesn't scream derby to me. It screams I was rear-ended and thrown into a ditch upside down. Holy cow. Yeah, that was a hard shot. Somebody hit on this thing on the road. Muffler still on it too. All factories it could be. Yeah, look at that roof on that thing. Jeez. Looks like they're still working on it though. They're trying to get it started. We'll see if this one gets a chance to run out there in the derby. Another mini car right here, the 917. Factory front bumper not swapped out on that. Almost looks like an old Geo. Maybe this could be an older Prism or a Toyota based on that bumper. Almost looks like it. We got a Caravan running the minivan class, Dodge Caravan, older square body box style Caravan, the 90s. SUV running in that same class, the 917X. That's a Honda SUV. I wonder if that's a Passport or wonder what that would be. Honda something for the SUVs. I don't know the Honda SUVs off the top of my head what they would all be. That one actually, this one's going to be interesting to watch the back of this guy. So this is one to remember in your little noggins when you're watching the derby. So the 917X is running the Honda SUV. This is actually a side opening hatch. What I mean by that is if you look, it's got the hinges on the side of the vehicle. This hatch swings open. And they're a whole different structural integrity. They latch different, way different than your hatch that opens up on the hinges. And I really want to see how that affects the back of a vehicle bending, having a side open hinge versus your swinging hatch from the top. So just something to think about, this black Honda on the 917X. Let's keep an eye on that when it runs and see if it bends anything different than the other ones. full-size truck running in the full-size class. Looks like maybe an older Dodge or an older Ford out here. This one's a clean one too. Boy, where are people pulling these older trucks out that are this clean? Heck, I see the ones on the road that are more rotten than this. My goodness. That's awesome. That one's rolling up. Full size. He's got tire flaps. And they must have passed that. He's got a stick. It's running the stock class. Got a Hurt chrome bumper on it. Starting to fold in. That core sport's just barely holding on. I mean, that bolt is just one hit away from sucking straight through there and peeling this whole thing sky high. If somebody comes in right here in an angle, they're going to right in there, and it's gone. So we'll see what that does. What?
This tank is sitting up
sideways. Is it really? The gas tank? Oh, that's because that's the factory gas tank. That's how they sit in these cars, these full-size cars. The gas tank sits right here behind the rear trunk. They don't lay flat. They stand straight up. So he had to mount it straight up and down just to run this thing. Usually you don't see the Crown Vicks, the 90s, the 2000s, you don't see guys running the factory tank in the back seat. They'll almost always have a derby tank. They drop in these things. And that is a Dodge, by the way, guys. I just saw the emblem. It's a Ram. I was right. I didn't think it was a Ford. It's an older Dodge Ram. That'd be really cool to see. Factory bumper and all on the front of this thing. Really cool to see your older Dodge trucks coming out there to hit. And we got more. We have the 73, the full-size van. It's been repainted, but we know exactly what this is. I can tell by that front bumper. This is the one that was that school bus van. You guys have seen this run probably 3 times now, maybe more, because I wasn't here for every derby. For sure, it's ran 3 times, maybe 4 or 5 at this point. We're gonna see if it survives another run on this. It's starting to get to the point where it's getting rough, I would say, but unbelievably, the front bumper's still holding on. Has not come off. Still on there strong, and to be honest, the front frame isn't bad at all. It's holding its own. If I remember the last time I saw this thing, the biggest problem I had was this front tire. Somebody got in there and it was starting to twist or bend. It had some steering issues, so that's obviously been straightened out for it. I just can't believe this van's been around so long. But geez, it's starting to really ball up in the back. There's the back bumper, the factory bumper. It's ripped off the frame, and it's rolled up on top of the frame rails. It's pushing in on top of the doors, which actually could be a good thing, because it's going to hold your 2 doors together now, and you're going to hit with them and hit with your frame rails. So that's pretty cool. But that wheel's a little bent too on the front. Look at that. So that'll be interesting to see if this thing can. I'm really honestly want to see how many runs they can get out of a full-size van at this point. You guys that are watching this, if you're around this area, this is a really good class to get into if you're used to running full-size vehicles and you don't want to go out there and buy a Crown Vic or pay the money for your 70s old iron. Start looking for an older 70s van, an 80s van. Go find one of them. They'd be really fun to run. And clearly, if you can keep the suspension together, obviously guys are running these things multiple times and have one heck of a time with these. So that's pretty cool. Right next to them, 357 Magnum truck. Out here running in the full-size class as well. So it's definitely, what, 4 or 5 now we've seen? That's good. We got good numbers coming in for this to be a decent show. Right next to this, looks like we have, looks like a little Honda or Toyota. Back bumper kind of looks like here. Oh, that's right, Toyota. It's an older style. Probably your older Corollas. If I were guessing based on the back of that thing mounted on it. Yeah, that's an older Corolla. Yep. And what else do we have? Oh yes, we can't miss the old Jurassic Park vehicle. About walked right past this thing. I think it's a Chevette, an older style. Somebody correct me if I'm wrong here, just go off the top of my head. I can't even tell you the last time I seen one of these even on the road or even in a derby. It has been years. I mean, years and years. The last time I would have seen one of these would have been, gosh, I want to say 7, 8 years ago or more, and it was at the Jay County Fair Derby. I remember specifically one of them came and ran in that show. That's just crazy. But see the emblems there? Yeah, I think it's a Chevette based on the label on the back of that thing. Can't read too much on it. But how's this thing look? Is it clean? You bet your butt is. Look at that. It ain't bad at all. That's really clean. My goodness. That's in really good shape, and it's an automatic, not even a manual. That's unbelievable. So we'll see how this thing does. Back in the day, it was very common to see these things in the derby world. See if they can still prove their worth nowadays against the modern cars, or if it's just gonna get beat up because it's something different and oddball. Sometimes that happens, but I love the Jurassic Park theme. That is so cool. Real quick, I wanna catch the old Blue Thunder that I missed. I hate when I miss cars. I feel bad because people don't get a chance. I don't shout them out. They're like, oh, you walked right past my car. But specifically, I want to talk about this car for a reason, why I'm coming over here. You guys, I'm gonna give a shout out right now to the old Painkiller crew, Alex McCracken. He's probably here somewhere. I know he's bringing stuff. We'll probably find him the other half of the pits. This was the car that went against him when he ran a derby just a couple weeks ago. Was it like Monroe Derby, perhaps, off the top of my head, a week or two ago? It was him versus this car, specifically Final 2. I won't tell you the outcome of that, but go check and see who won in the battle with his in-car camera fighting each other. But this car had the strangest thing happen in that derby. This entire wheel rolled off the car. I mean, rim, tire, just, he was driving it. Nobody even hit it. He was just driving, and the whole thing just went rolling away. Craziest thing. I don't know how that happened unless the lug nuts sheared off or they weren't tightened or what happened to it. If I see the guy, I'm probably going to ask him to see the story behind that. But this is, again, another square body Buick. So many of these are coming out to play, and it's an A-body, I can tell you, by that subframe, and it hasn't moved the frame yet, just moving the bumper shocks right now. Just blows me away how many of these are coming out to run at this show specifically. Rolling pretty good in the back, to be honest. It was notched. I could see where the head cuts in the frame rails. It's packed right in. This thing is doing amazing. That's exactly what you want it to do in the back. You want it to be soft. You want it to roll right in. It keeps the pressure off right there underneath your doors. That's cool. I'll keep an eye on this one when he runs, see how the back end of that does. But real quick, let's jump over to the other half of the pits that are down this path. All right, guys, we're back to the other half of the pits, which is all through here now. And this area is actually normally about three rows deeper. You've probably seen my other preludes to the Owen County Derbies, but it looks like all their rides and the carnies and the campers have all come this way into the pits. So they've sacrificed over half their pits to the festivals. Again, they're not used to this many vehicles. Normally a smaller derby this time around, but with their spring show being canceled, it's really packed in here. What we got here is the 24H of the Joey Hodge. Know this guy personally. He usually works and helps out in this derby, but he does occasionally find a car to go run and have some fun with. And gosh, what is this thing? This one's throwing me for a loop. Is it a Nissan? Front bumper's a strange little feller. Let's see if we could find an emblem on this. Century, Saturn. What is it? I got right on the Nissan guess. There's the steering wheel.
It's a Maxima.
Okay. That is something different and exciting to see. I love seeing different stuff. You know how much lately I have been buying weird cars and trying to run some different stuff. Firsthand, I'm going to tell you right now, I've seen only one of these run. It ran on pavement and it held up phenomenally for a pavement derby, and they did bare minimum to it. So, high hopes for Joey here running this thing. The only downside is I really don't have a lot of faith in that front bumper. It looks just like a Subaru bumper, and the Subaru bumpers that are that same design are absolute garbage. They're tin. They flatten and fold in the middle in a heartbeat. Two shots and that bumper's gonna have all kinds of problems. But the frames on these things are absolutely nasty on the fronts. Look how thick that is. Really tall, thick front frame. So that's probably why they're so darn tough. Reminds me almost like the Dodge Stratus front frame. Of how tall them things are in there. So that'll be cool to see that thing out there running. I don't know if this is mini or mid-size. Sometimes they label them on the doors. If I catch it, mid. So see this little trick I'll tell you guys. You see that writing right there? When they run these things through tech, they label these cars because Owen County sorts all of their cars based on wheelbase. So yeah, there's the man himself, Mr. Joey. Running this Nissan Maxima. I guess what it was. It was a Nissan. I was trying to figure out which one, but
99 Maxima.
They're tough little boogers. We had one run pavement and it did really well. But to be honest, I'm gonna say your back bumper's probably stronger than your front bumper. So probably a back end game for this car. But with the Owen track as big as it is very hard to keep your front end clean. Any driver can attest to that. It is a lot of slingshotting cars flying from one end to the other, and you get spun around in the middle, a lot of crazy stuff comes at you. Let this golf cart come zooming by real quick. And let's zip over to the other side. Excuse me, gentlemen. What other crazy stuff do we have over here? That looks like a Ford Focus, if I were guessing from here. Back window's a dead giveaway, those little triangle guys. Plus the back bumper is a Ford back bumper. Dead giveaway is that little point right there in the middle, similar to your Tauruses. The old Focus, we've seen them run. Heck, we even drive one of these as a daily right now. Might even be the exact same style and year that we drive as a daily driver. Looks just like it. You've heard me say it before. I don't like them as derby cars. I really don't. I'm not sold, guys. I'd run a Cavalier before I'd run a Focus. I just don't like the front frames. Front bumpers usually snap in half. Frame rails, they have these crazy little notches. You can kind of see them when you look on the sides of the frame. You see all those little teeth that are in that. Those little notches just kick all over the place when these things bend like an accordion. They're real weird. But the back ends are ridiculous on them things. Right next to it, we have another car I'm excited to see. This here is a Dodge Caliber. And I can tell by this era of car, all the Dodges have a very similar front bumper. They got these, almost looks like a fist, I call it, like a punching fist on the corners, and then your bumper in the middle. They're okay stock bumpers. They'll hold up for like a heat run, a one and done kind of thing. But they will flatten, they will be in the middle sooner or later. Biggest kicker for these Dodge Calibers, I know right off the bat, they have aluminum spindles. And if this guy didn't change them, that's gonna be the downfall. I can't tell by looking back in there whether they're aluminum or steel. We're gonna know right away. The first hit to this wheel, if it don't break and you see these front wheels actually bend over and not break, then they're steel. If they break on the first hit, then they're definitely aluminum because they are very weak aluminum for these things. So that'll be interesting to see how that does. But besides that spindle problem, these are really tough vehicles, and I want to see somebody get the chance to build one. I've not seen a built one anywhere around me yet. Go out there and run with the other cars, see what kind of craziness they could do. I feel like the back would be really stout on them. It's kind of like an HHR, very similar to them. And an HHR has the exact same problem. It also has the exact same aluminum spindles. So you find something good that you can bolt into these, problem solved. These would be nasty little cars that go run. But he's probably running midsize as well. We'll see that out there. Sitting over here, newer style Honda, maybe. Almost looks like Nissan. A Honda bumper. What is it?
Nissan.
They got me fooled, guys. First thing I've messed up on all night, we got a Nissan. Almost pegged it as the wrong thing. Oddball little thing. It's a Versa. Aha, no wonder it had me fooled. We ain't seen many of these come into the derby world yet. These guys are going to be the pioneers for this tonight. If they go out there and win, everyone's going to say they're awesome. If they go out there and get destroyed in one hit, then everyone's going to say they're junk. And I'm guessing they've probably never seen one run either. So this will be a fun little thing to see. But yeah, that bumper is dang near identical to a Honda bumper. It really throws you there. We'll see if it holds up though, or if it just... The Honda ones are terrible bumpers. Let's hope the Nissan bumpers are better. But I'm curious about this. This will be kind of cool to see. We're getting more and more into the newer era of demolition derby vehicles. But boy, that back bumper looks pretty stout. I like that better than the front. This may be a really good back end car. Let that pack in straight. It reminds me a lot of your Toyota rear bumpers that are right in there. So the number 824 Nissan Versa. Watch for that one out there, guys. That'll be cool. The Power Wheels getting ready to head out here soon. Whole crew heading out with them. My goodness. Okay, let's pick it up. I'm slowing down. I'm talking too much. We got the 712. Looks like we got us a Taurus. I can tell it's a Taurus because the bumper shocks are different on a Sable. Dead giveaway. Got a Taurus. It's a pre-ran. It's coming here to have fun. Still has factory bumper staying on it. So he's going to go out there and have some fun with this. Use it up. Looks a little bent. Just a little on that front wheel. What's going on, guys? Now these guys, they got a whole crew of cars here, and we're about to see their lineup when we get a chance to walk through them all. Let me tell you what, these guys have been building fiends running these cars, and if you want to know who they are, it's a dead giveaway. If you want a hint, Look at the driver's doors. You're going to see all of them that say low fuel racing on them.
Low fuel's from here.
All the way down is this whole squad of cars. Now keep in mind, there wasn't a spring show, so they did have a little bit of help building cars because they started and they had cars for that show, but they've been building for this too. These have been busy guys. And I got a feeling we're gonna see them probably in minis, we're gonna see them in mid, we're gonna see them in vans. They're gonna be representing a lot of different classes tonight.
Hey, how are you guys?
So it'll be cool to see these guys. And the real cool thing with these guys are, this is a lot of good stock cars with a lot of good variety to see how they're gonna hold up for them. These guys also run Fords, so you know, I always have a sweet spot in my heart for these darn Tauruses. And they also know how well these things do for stock class, so props to them for always bringing some of them to have some fun with. This one looks clean. This one looks good. It still actually has the rockers. That's a dead giveaway for a good Taurus. I bet you it's got a floor too. Yeah, it does. Look at that. Not too bad.
Make sure to check out the Sable. It has no floor.
Oh, the Sable has no floor. That's not good. I would be worried being in that one. I've been with them.
It's the multi-cup.
And then we got the splatter paint job here of the old Toyota Camry. He's got a GoPro. Look at that. That'll be cool to have hanging right there riding with him. We got the PT Cruiser running the mini class 611. Took one hit to the front bumper already. Might have been a wrecked car, not sure. And also right here with them, we got another Toyota here, another Toyota Camry. Factory bumper even has the little corner bump guard still on it. And these guys, I mean, these cars are as is. Gut them and go. Super basic. Have some fun. Their crew always brings a heat. I love that. His back bumper suck my brick. With the brick paint job, that's pretty good. That's classy. I like that. That's funny. That's a good deal.
The mini.
I had problems with these stupid lug nuts on when I ran one. People come along there and they catch them. They don't shear them off, but they bend the crap out of them. And if you need to change tires for a second run, you dang near have to cut them off.
I'm hoping.
He's even got the old cursed locked lug nut with the key. Those suck, man. If you got to get in there and you don't have the key for them, you might as well get the torch. They're a bastard. Yep, I've been there before. I had that problem back in the full-size days. I had some 80s cars with them on it. Up here, we got another Camry. Okay, these guys are starting to switch it up to Camrys, but they still got some Fords, so we're gonna see. We're gonna play a little game tonight. Low fuel racing, we know their cars are all built the exact same. We're gonna see if the Camrys in a completely bone stock form, factory bumpers, will outlast the bone stock Fords, because everyone loves their Camrys, but in a completely bone stock form, I think the Camrys have some weaknesses compared to some of these Fords. We're gonna see. This one here is the Sable. I know it's a Sable because the hood has the double fold down. It also has a different bumper shock on the rear, but he said check this one out. Let's go check it out. Over here, not too bad. Not too bad. Let's look over there. Ooh, that's not good. We're gonna take you around. You guys gotta see this passenger side. That's not pretty. Hopefully he's got a floor underneath his feet. Oh yeah, that is gone. I have seen worse, don't get me wrong, for the Fords. Yeah, so it might be okay, to be honest. He does have a floor up here by the firewall. That is the most important thing. Your subframe's gonna move if you don't have a floor there. These Fords are just, the way the frame is designed on them, they utilize the floor and the roof as part of the unibody for these cars. The whole unibody does not run the full length of these cars. You absolutely need a good floor and a good roof to hold these things together, and it'll cause havoc. You wait, if this thing lasts long enough and that rolls into this tire here, this whole tire will shift in and this floor is going to give right here and shove all the way up to where this seat and that center console is. This seat bar will actually twist and be like this on an angle by the end of the night if it lasts long enough to put the abuse into the back of the car. So we'll see what that does. Right next to him here, we got a minivan they're running. Dodge Chrysler, I could tell by the front bumper, that's another Dodge Grand Caravan. Everybody loves the old caravans for these minivan classes. That's the dominating force, pretty much the Toyota Camry of the minivans. Right next to it, exact same thing, another Dodge Caravan, front bumper, dead giveaway. These are the older style, I can tell by the bumper. Not the old 90s, but definitely your probably mid to late 90s, based on how that bumper's on there. So these things are tough little boogers. And then right here, we got an N-body. Now, I'm calling it an N body because that's the type of frame this was built on from the factory, but it's probably like your Malibu, your Grand Am, your Alero. The Alero is a two-door, so it's probably not an Alero, but I'm going to say a Malibu or a Grand Am based on that front end. Is it?
Malibu, yep.
Yeah, old Malibu. These things, you guys remember when I built my Alero, white car, spider paint job. We used the back end pretty much the whole time. Got second place because my aluminum spindle broke, just like this car has. And probably what will take this car out, possibly the weakest aluminum spindle I have ever found to date. So far, any car I've been under, I've looked at, this is the thinnest one. I'm pretty certain you can hit it with a sledgehammer and crack the aluminum spindle. I mean, I don't know how these cars survived hitting a pothole on the road, because I feel like you hit a good bump and it's gonna shatter all by itself. It's that weak. But boy, if you can switch those out. I really love the subframes on these. I love the unibody frames. The four cylinders got a lot of room under the hood. They're fun cars. With that being said though, I'm pretty sure the Malibu here is not a four cylinder. It's probably, yep, that is a six cylinder 3100, just like your Luminous. So it will get hot. It will have limp mode if it doesn't blow the spindle out of it at least. What do we got here? Somebody switched the bumper on this one. Is it welded or bolted? It is neither, ladies and gentlemen. This bumper is only held on by that thin wire. Boy, that is gonna be interesting to see if it stays. I think the bumper is going to slide. I think it's going to do this when it gets hit, because that's not tight enough. I don't know if it'll snap off, but it's gonna shift it. And if somebody comes in really hard, right like this, and pops that bumper, I could absolutely see it just go shooting right off the car like a spear and go that way into the arena. This would be a fun one to watch if I can remember the old 730. Definitely going to be easy to remember this guy because he's the one that has the skeleton riding in the back with him. I'm guessing it's going to be there for the Derby because he tied it on. I don't know. We'll see if he takes it out before the Derby. Boy, I hope that's there. That would be hilarious. See if he stays on for the whole time of the Derby. But yeah, definitely interesting with the wired on front bumper. We'll see how that works out. We got another Ford here. This one's actually starting to roll up, pack in. Ford Taurus starting to roll. Is it rotten? Is it clean? What's the answer? It is clean. We got a good one. And with it rolling up, it should be pretty good in the back. How's the front? Good front end on this thing too. Good front bumper still. This is the Sable hood that's on this guy. What's going on, guys? There's the old painkiller crew. Did you guys see that Buick that you fought here?
Yeah,
second place one?
I know, Dave.
I saw that thing over there. Hey, what was the story on his wheel? What made it roll off?
The wheel just broke. Like, the wheel broke off.
The studs?
Yeah. No, the studs, like the actual physical wheel.
Oh, the center of the wheel.
Came out.
Okay. So. There's our answer, guys. I was talking about it earlier. That whole thing just rolled straight out of there, snapped the center of the wheel out. I'll be dang, that's crazy. Wonder if it was an aluminum wheel or not. I have to almost go back and watch the video. This looks like another older Dodge Chrysler product. Based on that bumper, I would say so. Looks just like my Plymouth bumper, mid-class. Probably another, oh, yep, it's Chrysler labels right there. Chrysler Imperial, ladies and gentlemen, just like the other one we saw, but this one is more fresh, hasn't packed into the back end. Back end all day, front ends go straight down. Another end body right here with no plastic bumper. This one is either a Malibu or a Grand Am. I'm gonna say Grand Am because it has those body lines, dead giveaway for sure on this guy. But again, tough cars, aluminum spindles. And we're almost walking our way through all these cars. We'll make our way around really quick. Let's pick it up a little bit. We've eaten up some time. We got a Honda here, the 03 coming to play. Looks like a Honda Accord. No, Honda Civic based on that back window, if I were to guess. And we also have another newer car. Is that another Aveo? It is. Another Aveo coming out to play. More of these starting to pop up. Fresh one hasn't been ran. We'll see what it does. Not much front on these cars. My goodness, are they short? Really curious to see if it will hold its own or just go backwards maybe the whole time. And then we got the last bit of lineup. Oh, I take it back. There's a whole nother row back there. Let's start walking. We aren't going to miss some of these. There's some good ones back through here for sure.
We should go.
What else do we have? 28W. Looks like a front wheel drive car coming to run the class. That's boy, a Dodge maybe, or a Chevy, can't tell from here. Another front wheel drive car running the mini class right there. All these guys, there's a Cavalier back bumper on that thing. Full size, the 01W coming here to run. We've seen this one run before. It's back from last year. I'm pretty certain we saw that. That one's another plastic front bumper on the front of that thing. Here's a town car, factory front bumper on the town car. We're coming in the stock class. We've got a full size town car right there. Oh, he's got a bear hanging out. That is so cool, hanging out with that one. Up here is a car where you guys are probably all going to recognize. The number 3 Beersmobile. This is the Camry that just ran at my event, which was the Circle City Raceway July, the 4th of July weekend. We ran another derby right after my June derby. And he ran this there, and it got taken out mid-derby because of right here. It got that strut laid over, the steering laid over, and it still looks kind of rough. So he's going to guard that thing a lot this derby. Like, the whole frame rail is actually leaned over and pushed in. It's starting to roll it. And the bad news is once it does that, it gets into the shifter on these Camrys. That's not good news for him. So, boy, that doesn't look good. But it looks like he's got a brand new CV axle. He's got a brand new strut back in there. He put some parts into this to get it here and fix it pretty darn quick with that turnaround time. So we'll see how it does out there running. I think it's him running it and not his wife. His wife ran the Lumina and ended up winning my June derby in the Lumina pink vehicle. Over here's another vehicle you guys are gonna recognize the driver from. The Painkiller running the Subaru wagon. This is the one he just ran and went against that other Buick with. Pretty much exactly as it was. Factory front bumper, that's the Subaru bumpers. You remember, I just talked about them a little bit ago with another vehicle. I said that front bumper looks very similar to a Subaru bumper. That was the Joey Hodge vehicle we talked about. Well, here's what I'm talking about when I say the Subaru bumper is flattened. Look at this. It is completely flat as a pancake. It didn't V, it didn't twist, it just mushes. So it buys you some time on the frame by that bumper flattening. But once it flattens, this bumper likes to twist and do some really crazy things. So we'll see how it works out for him. Back end's packing straight in. Not blowing down, not locking up his wheels yet. Getting close. I don't even know if he switched anything on this. I don't think he had any flat tires. He probably drug it home, hit it with a hammer, called it good, and hits here to derby again, round 2. He's happy with it. He got a top 3 with it, so why not go use the car up? He's just like me. He's made some money. He doesn't care where it places tonight. So I'm sure we'll see that on his channel with the GoPro. Right next to him, we got the Painkiller SUV with the chainsaw roof sign. Love that sign. Yeah, we got a Nissan Pathfinder. I'm excited to see this thing run, truth be told. And if I know Painkiller, I bet you he's running it front-wheel drive. He's done that before on one of his other SUVs. He kind of liked it. He could just use the back end way all the way up to the gas tank, ignore the axle shots, not worry, drive it basically like a front-wheel drive car. And I bet you it is going to run front-wheel drive. It's going to be with the SUVs in advance, don't get me wrong, but he probably pulled the drive shaft and has it running because you can see the CV axles still in there for the front of this. But unfortunately, that is a really small front bumper, my goodness. So let's hope, with that bumper being that short, nobody comes riding here and just smokes a front wheel on a corner shot and just rips straight off the car, pulls the axle out, A-arm and all that crazy jazz. That'll be curious to see, but rooting for that one, Nissan Pathfinder, you know me and something different. See if it holds its own against the common stuff out there. We got the last vehicles rolling in. We got an Elantra come rolling in here. This old boy came rolling in. Let me tell you what, his door was wide open on the trailer coming down the road. This is about as simple as it gets, guys. He's wired the door shut just about how I ran my Dodge. Wrap it around the pillar, call it good enough, and go send it. Not wasting any money or wire down lower on the doors these days. I personally really like these cars. This is on my list to buy. The Elantra is one I want to experiment with. I really like the front frames. I really like the engines. There's a lot of room on the four cylinders. They do have a subframe. It's just something not many people have gotten the chance to experiment with yet. So we'll see how this one does. We'll probably come back here and check it out after the Derby just for my own benefit. I want to get a feel for them if I ever do run one. It's probably dark, so I won't have video of that on the aftermath. I always come back here. You'll see me in the pits late into the night talking to people. Let me get a shot of this hood. The old Cap'n Crunch. That's some pretty good artwork. That's going to get destroyed real quick. So the 5150 on the Elantra. We'll keep an eye out for that and see how it does. This is a newer style Elantra, guys. This is like 2000s, like 04, 09? Oh, I was going to say an 04 or 05. It's much newer. 09. Check that bad boy out. We're going real new on the Elantras. That's pretty awesome. So cool to see that one. And we have our very first and maybe only W-body. Can you believe it, guys? We've gotten finally to the point in the Derby world where the Luminas, the Monte Carlos, the W-bodies are running out. There's not many left. We don't see many here at all come into play. This one's a clean one, at least from the front. Subframe solid, unibody solid, factory front bumper. We'll see how it does out there. The 586. Coming to run this thing, old Batman logo on it. Might be the only Lumina coming to play today. If he pulls off the win being the only W body, then we're gonna give him some points and still give a little bit of credit to the W body holding superior. But I'm going to guess, because he's the only Lumina, might be a target by the other guys that still view them as quite the threat. We got an older Toyota right here. This is like your 80s Toyota. I'm almost certain that's what it is based on the bumper. Like an older Camry. It's definitely an 80s Camry bumper. And then right next to it, this thing here is a really cool one to see. I saw this spring when they had the show that got rained out. I know exactly what this is. We have one sitting in our collection. You guys have seen it. This is my golf cart. This is a Toyota Echo. And they weren't made for many years. I want to see this one run. It's been hurt. It got smoked hard right here. And it is just rolling that whole frame rail over. But yeah, this is exactly what I have right now as a golf cart back home on the farm. Let's see if they're good Derby cars. If these are junk, then that'll tell us what we're going to do with ours in the future. 04, we got a full-size Chevy 1500 coming to play. Here's a change of pace. We got the 92 of the David Janes. This guy normally is almost always in a full-size car. And he's out there hitting, tearing it up in the full-size. This is going to be cool to see a full-size driver switching it up and going with the full-size trucks. So still the V8 rear-wheel drive mentality, but a different style of class going against the vans and trucks. See if he can go out there and still pull off getting really good placement on a new style class. I think this might be your Chevy truck, if I'm not mistaken. The back seat in it. Shorter bed, yep. Chevy truck. I'm not as familiar off the top of my head with the old trucks just because you don't see them much and it's just starting to pick up with this class. So excited to see him out there, a full-size guy coming to play with the trucks. The old 17J, James Miller himself out here running full-size, change of pace. Last couple times we've seen the Superman run, it's actually been mini cars. Heck, we even saw him here run a Taurus back in the day with the Superman getup. He also ran at my Speedrome Derby on pavement this year for the spring show in a pre-ran car. So he's out here running the limited weld, mod, full size, whatever they call it these days class. The most built class for full size that they're having tonight. So see how he does. A96, another full size truck. There we go, guys. We're getting some attention now on this new class. That's an F-150, the first full size Ford we've seen in this class. Everything else, we've got two or three Chevys, a couple of vans, we got that Dodge truck, but this is the first Ford truck we've seen so far. Right next to him, another full size, just like the other Chevy right down there we looked at. Another Chevy with the back seat in it, the bigger cab. That one looks a little bit higher suspension on it. Walk our way, wrap things up. Get my feet moving, guys. We got a pre-ran. Maybe it's 729, maybe it's 44. Who knows? There's two roof signs, so we don't know. But it's running the full-size stock class on the old iron coming to play. This one's also running full-size stock. Looks like an older Caddy. Yep. Older style Cadillac, but it's back-wheel drive, so maybe it's like a Seville, perhaps. Off the top of my head, maybe that's what it is. What do we got last in our crew? We got another Park Avenue, which is basically your Buick LeSabre. See how this thing holds up. This one still has 38. Yep, same exact case, 3800 motor in these bad boys. Another old iron full size coming to play in the stock class. Pre-ran just like the other one. Going to use this one up. And right next to him, we got a newer Ford out there in the full size stock class. And right next to him, a newer Ford in the full size stock class. We're just going up through the decades through each one of these vehicles. Lincoln Town Car back there in the full size stock. A lot of full size stock cars. What do we got hiding back here? Why is this thing way back here? There's not a... Is there a stick on it? Maybe he's running... Don't know. We got a Pontiac Montana that basically looks like it just got built right now in the pits. He's got a stick, so he's running. It is plastic bumper cover and all. Heck, he's even got a little bit of glass on the back. I wouldn't be surprised if he built this thing today. That's straight to the point. And ladies and gentlemen, we have W body number 2. Now, I'm not gonna say this is the same though, because this is a newer gen W body, whole different subframe, different everything, but still very tough. It's Buick Century. Seen one run twice at my shows just recently. Circle City, that green one, was a Buick Century. Ran back to back 2 weeks in a row. So they're tough little cars. See if it outlives the Lumina, I guess. Oh, I almost walked past this one. Thought it was just a normal truck someone drove here. This is an F-150 running in the full size class. This is a short bed though, so that'll be different. And he also took off the tailgate. This is the first truck we've seen in this class run without a tailgate. Help him, hurt him, I don't know. It'd be fun to see what it does. Hopefully that wire don't get hooked on someone. And right behind him, we have a Toyota minivan running in the minivan class. And that's bringing us to the last couple that are sitting here. Another Jimmy. Nope, that's a Blazer. Almost the same thing. Running with the minivans. And the last couple that we have here. Thank goodness it is a decent weather today. It rained all day yesterday and this place was, oh, I bet you was a mud hole. Owen is pretty notorious for standing water because there's a massive river right behind here. And if they get a flood, it will flood this entire place. Pits, track, everything underwater. Another W body, number 3 now for W bodies. This one's a Grand Prix. I personally like the Grand Prix more than the Buick Centuries. I feel like they're heavier and they have more pushing power. This one also has a 3800 in it, so you know how much I love those motors. See how that thing does for them. Last couple of cars right here. We got an old Toyota Tercel sitting back there for minis. We got another mini right here that I can't even name off the top of my head. Almost looks like a Ford Tempo maybe, or something based on those rims. Look like Ford rims, but yeah, it's a Ford steering wheel. I'm gonna say it might be a Tempo. Could be off on the name, but pretty close. And we have a mini pickup truck, the 07. I think this truck would run with the minivans. I don't think they're gonna put him with the big ones. He would be absolutely gobbled up. So we'll probably see him with the SUVs and minivan class. Then we got 13D Buick LeSabre out here running with the other ones. The third one of these we've seen today now. They're starting to become more popular. Fun little cars if they keep the electrical clean on these things. But that wraps it up, guys. People are in the stands. This has been a long, long prelude. I hope you enjoyed it. It might be one of my longest ones we've ever done, but hey, we haven't done any in so long. Get ready for the Owen County Derby. We've got tons of classes tonight, tons of fun. We got great weather and a lot of really fun oddball vehicles to get smashed up.